Songs. Are we ready? Okay. Summer in the city, back of my neck getting dirty and gritty. Been down, isn't it a pity? Doesn't seem to be a shadow in the city. All around, people looking half dead, walking on the sidewalk harder than a match. But at night, it's a different world. Go out and find a girl. Come on, and dance all night. Despite the heat, it'll be alright, babe. Don't you know it's a pity that be like the nights in the summer, in the city, in the summer, in the city. Cool town, evening in the city, dressing so fine and looking so pretty. Cool cat, looking for a kitty, go and look at every corner of the city. Till I'm wheezing like a bus stop, running up the stairs, gonna meet you on the rooftop. Can I have some of what you guys have been smoking?
Oh, score out there. All right, here we go. One, two, three, four.
There is a great big mystery, and it sure is worrying me. It's the diddy wah diddy, Mr. Diddy wah diddy. Won't somebody tell me what diddy wah diddy means? I went out and I walked around. Someone shouted out, "Hey, look who's in town, Mr. Diddy wah diddy, Mr. Diddy wah diddy." Won't somebody tell me what diddy wah diddy means? Well, I had a little girl about 4 feet four. She said, "Come on, Daddy, just give me some more of your diddy wah diddy, Mr. Diddy wah diddy." I wish somebody would tell me what diddy wah diddy means. Stick it, Daniel. Lady sat on it, she said, "Daddy, that sure is sweet. It's my diddy wah diddy. I wish somebody would tell me what diddy wah diddy means." I said, "Sister, I'll soon be gone. Just give me that ticket that you're sitting on. It's my diddy wah diddy, and I need it. Don't somebody tell me what diddy wah diddy means." Then I got throwed out of the church because I talk about diddy wah diddy too much. Mr. Diddy wah diddy, won't somebody tell me what diddy wah diddy
serious, okay?
That's the problem with doing silly, serious songs like that. You come to a serious one, no
one does that. And we're drilling them into insanity now.
I know. This is a song by Canadian singer-songwriter Bruce Coburn, one of the extraordinary Canadians, for my money, every bit as good as Leonard Cohen and probably just as depressing. Razor blades will be handed out at the conclusion of this song. Some of what you were smoking. Have you got the munchies too? No chocolate, that's the thing. Chocolate. Okay, so this is called Pacing the Cage. Now, I tell you that because sometimes, for some reason, people do misunderstand the words and turn it into a mondegreen of some sort.
For the whole song, I thought you were saying pissing in the cage. And it just, it was much funnier than it was.
Okay, here we go. Sunset is an angel weeping, holding out a bloody sword. No matter how I squint, I cannot make out what it's pointing toward. Sometimes you feel you've lived too long. Days drip slowly on the page, and you catch yourself pacing the cage. I've proven who I am so many times. A magnetic strip swarm and thin, and each time I was someone else, and everyone was taken. Powers chatter in high places, stir up eddies in the dust. I never knew what you all wanted, so I gave you everything. All that I could pillage, all the spells that I could sing. It's as if the thing were written. Sometimes the best map will not guide you. You can't tell what's round the bend. Sometimes the road leads through dark places. Sometimes the darkness is your friend. Today these eyes scan bleached out land. Now, this is a song that ideally we should turn the lights down for.
All right.
What do you reckon, Dennis? Can we bring them down? Yeah.
That's a horrible thing. But next time, that won't be there. They'll have a little song. 12 string
down. Thank you.
Yeah. Perfect.
That's great. Yes, that's spot on. Now, I do need one volunteer for this song. A lady.
Preferably not.
I always make a phone call then.
Nah, it's all right. Thank you. do, I think. Sorry about that. I just did a picture again. Now, this is a song that you have to use your imagination for. The folks down the back are buzzing away, I'm sure. It came out of the dashboard, barely 2 feet from her face, as the heating fan inside of it began to oscillate. She could not believe her eyes, she thought the vent had come alive. As the probing legs came blackly through the grate, and a spiky sheet of fear flew up her back, she fought to force her fingers to relax. But with one eye on the grate, she stared blindly at the brake, and the battered hole and skidded off the track. It squeezed past the plastic, fell forward with a plop. She screamed and watched it run back through the car. Like a herky-jerky doll spring loaded in a box, she catapulted through the door onto the tar. And the night air hit her body like a blow. It was very nearly 10 degrees below. On the back road to Cowan Cove, and from the lights of Ginderbine, she'd been running with the coming of the snow. This is the chorus. You can sing along with this. And it's somewhere in the car, Lord, it's somewhere in the car. The cabin light's not working and the night is deathly dark. You know there's matches somewhere, but you don't know where they are. And the bloody thing is somewhere in the car. She'd driven down from Sydney where it must have got on board. She knew it was a funnel web. She'd seen the things before, but they're rarely quite as large or as ugly or as vast as the thing that she'd seen running on the floor. So she cracked the driver's rear door open wide, but the light was gone. She couldn't see it. I'll try it again. But the moon was gone. She couldn't see inside. Under the empty biscuit packets and discarded burger wrappers, there were far too many places it could hide. And it's somewhere in the car, Lord, it's somewhere in the car. The cabin light's not working and the night is deathly dark. You know there's matches somewhere, but you don't know where they are. Do you? And the fucking thing is somewhere in the car. So she got up and walked around the hole, and as it lay there in the ditch like a wounded beast, she knew no one else was coming up the road from Cowan Coban that night. And she wondered what the hell she was going to do. Several feet of fallen tree had come in through the grill, and the one remaining headlight glimmered dimly in the chill. And the first few flakes of white spun and danced along the light as the blizzard came in howling from the hills. And the horror of a situation dawned. She knew she'd freeze unless she sheltered from the storm. With every nightmare that she'd known, she climbed back inside the Holden, driven by the desperation to be warm. Through the hours of the darkness, she stared into the blackness, every muscle in her body quivering in wild alarm. Every time she thought she heard it as it skittered through the papers, every time she thought she felt it on her arm. And the howling mountain blizzard wrapped its fingers round their prison, and the storm clouds blotted out the stars. Hell isn't hot at all, she thought. It's colder than the grave. And it runs on silently inside this car. Now the spider died at midnight, frozen by the alpine air. But as it fell down from the roof, there was a scream of wild despair. And the next day they found her there with a catatonic stare, and the funnel web still tangled in her hair. So they searched a woman's body for a bite. There was none, but she was dead. I see why. And the coroner said probably a stress-related coronary. Because he didn't want to say she died of fright. And somewhere in the car, oh, somewhere in the car, the cabin light's not working and the night is deathly dark. You know there's magic somewhere, but you don't know where they are. Magic is somewhere in the car. Now, there's a scientist on the Sunday social page who's just been married to a girl who's half his age. Well, back in his laboratory at Sydney University, there's a funnel web that's missing from its cage. Poets, of course, and Dennis, the next one is on in 4 weeks.
The 13th. The 13th of August, Sunday the 13th.
Sunday the 13th of August. Come along, bring your friends, have a great time. Thanks again. Great night.